So hello guys, I'm my humble self Chukwu Kobilago, and in this video I just want to talk about the second aspect of the second information that is on the latest blog by the TBC admin. The first one was about migration requests. Okay, now the second is about people having a mentality that TBC is money. So as such, you don't treat it as if you don't treat it as if it's something that you're doing somebody a favor, or you treat it like a lackadaisical, okay, with a lackadaisical attitude. Okay, now you can in this that should be the third paragraph, okay, or the fourth paragraph. Okay, now let me read this word for word for you to guys to get the point, then I will not summarize. Okay, those that have migrated already may have noticed that they did not verify their email account in the process of migration on the new wallet. My biggest concern has to do with passwords on the new wallet. People need to be better at personally responsible, at being personally responsible. TBC is money. You are 100% responsible to remember your password to your new wallet. If you forget your password, you have lost all of your TBC money. There is no way to recover your password to your new wallet at this time. Okay, remember, at this time. So when you register a new wallet, you are asked to enter your password twice. Okay, don't copy and paste it, type it out twice. That way you know you got it right. Most of us have had experience of losing our money because we misplaced or lost our wallet somewhere. We all feel really bad when that kind of thing happens. If you forget your password on the new wallet, then you have lost all of your TBC money and admin will not replace it. Okay? Sadly, too many members have attempted to scam admin with all sorts of stories regarding coins lost in the past, and I just need to be firm in this policy of personal responsibility that if you forget your password on the new wallet, then you have lost all of your TBC coin in it. This is no different from what is the case with most other cryptocurrency. So take this policy seriously and be responsible adults. So guys, you guys can see there is no margin for error when it comes to passwords. Okay, I can say this for a fact because cryptocurrency is part of what I do, and I know for sure that my blockchain.info account for Bitcoin does not do password recovery. Neither does my account for Ethereum, Bitcoin Cash, Dogecoin, Litecoin, or even Dash. Okay? There's no such, responsibility on the coin or the creators of the coin, okay, for such to happen. We're even lucky that we have a blog that we're reading, because in most other coins, you don't interact with whoever is the admin or whoever is in charge of the governance behind it. Okay? So guys, protect your password and understand that, remember what you used. Okay? TBC is money. Okay? You treat it the same way you treat your gold chain or your gold watch, or you treat it the same way you treat your wallet when it's filled up with cash. Keep it safe. And at the same time, remember what you use. That's why you were asked to put your password twice. Because in my experience with TBC, a lot of people have called me asking me, hey, I can't log into their account, I can't remember the password. Those days are gone. If you lose your password now, your TBC coin is gone forever. Okay, so guys, you guys need to understand this, that we need to take more responsibility. Okay, the fact that we are able to read blog posts by the TBC admin, the fact that you are able to interact with some of the top leaders in TBC does not give you the right not to be responsible. Okay, it does not give you the right not to be responsible. So you have to be responsible for your money, and TBC is money. Okay, so I just want to do this video to emphasize this, because I won't be surprised that some people already don't remember the password they really use, and I feel so sorry for them, because at this time there is no such support for password recovery, and because we do not verify the email, because there was no email verification in this process, because the admin believes that every single person who have done, because the admin believes that we are dealing with people, not email address, and that's why those who are paying the $10 fees are those who are migrating. Okay, so take more responsibility, guide your money with your life, same way you guide your paper money. And I wish you the best of luck, and I urge you to educate yourself more and educate those who you are introducing TBC, because whatever happens to you is what they're going to read as feedback. So you have to know it. You have to educate yourself to the best of your knowledge, or you learn from others. I learn from others. Okay, I learn from Randy Wilson. I learn from the TBC admin. I learn from Dan Lutz. Okay, you can learn from all these people, learn their success, be innovative yourself to create it, to be creative, and at the same time, take responsibility of your life. Okay, stop assigning blame to the TBC admin, because nobody put a gun to your head to join TBC, and nobody forced you to forget your password. Okay, so watch out for the last video, and this is about new members. How do we sign up new members given the new system? So, and the new wallet. Also, see you in the next video. Take care.